I'm not going to answer the questions in order. First of all, I just want to be clear. You know, the questions are for the ulama, okay, for the scholars of our religion, which I'm nowhere near. And I mean, the difference between being a scholar is probably like the difference between east and west. As far as you can go east, that's the ulama. And as far as you can go west, that's right. Probably a little farther than that. All right? But inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed us to be around some ulama and sit down with some ulama and hear other people ask them questions and listen to their responses and read from the books of their fatawa and, you know, ask our own personal questions that some of you already have. So we'll answer those questions, inshallah, based off of their answers only. All right? We don't have any answers for anybody. We have some advice, inshallah, and even our advice is from the books of the ulama. Our scholars have advised us, even those who require PhDs in Islamic studies. Al-Zamin Ahimullah, he sat down some of the PhDs from Jamiat al-Imam Muhammad ibn Saud al-Riyad, the Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Zamin, he sat them down before they left when he was alive, Ahimullah, and he asked, what's that, man? That's a, that's a Wali number? So, he sat them down and he said to them, he said, you brothers are not ulama. Graduated with a PhD from the Jamiat al-Imam Muhammad ibn Saud al-Riyad. This is the school where our major scholars are, you know, part of the alumni and the faculty, the overseas program, like scholars like Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan, scholars like Abdul Aziz Ali Sheikh, and these big ulama. They sat these PhDs down before they left and told them, Antum lassum al-ulama. You're not the scholars. You are mubalighun. Your job is to connect the world with the scholars of our religion. So, you know, this is what we've been instructed to do. The PhDs were instructed to do that. So you know that's my situation and everyone knows, inshallah ta'ala. So we have to try to stick to that if we want success. All right? So one of the questions, and we're not going to answer them in order based off of, you know, what's presented, but we're going to try to sift through them and see which ones are that I think is probably the most relative to our situation as a whole, and work our way down, inshallah ta'ala. One of the very important questions was, what is the definition of a scholar and who determines who a scholar is? This question was asked to many scholars and they answered this question. First, we understand their status, right? What is the definition of a scholar? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the scholars in the Quran, يَغْفِرِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ وَالْجَهْدِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has raised up those who believe from amongst you in general, right? The believers have been raised up in general. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ دَرَجَاتِ. The people who believe in Allah, He already raised them up in degree, or already raised them up in level, or, you know, above the rest of the people. The people who are upon kufr and shirk and worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they don't have this fadl from Allah, this virtue from Allah. Those people who have iman, Allah raised them up. He said, وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتِ. But those who have been given knowledge, they've been raised up to even more degrees. Okay, so in general, all the believers are raised up, right? But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as al-Imam Qurtubi rahimahullah, he said, this is dhikrul khas ba'd al-'am. This one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned something specific after he mentioned something general. Okay? So first Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that all the people of Iman are raised up in general. Then he mentioned that the people who have been given knowledge were raised up in more degrees. In more degrees. He raised them up in more degrees. Right? Some Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned the Quran. هَلْ يَسْتَوِ الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Are those who have knowledge like those who don't have knowledge? Okay? When the Salaf used to explain this verse, like in Thawri, okay, in Kathir, the ulama of the past would explain this verse, they would say, absolutely not. The answer to this question that Allah asked, this rhetorical question, is absolutely not. Those people who believe in knowledge, they're not like the people who don't have knowledge. We just mentioned a verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, He raised up those who have been given knowledge in degrees over the regular believer. Okay? So the people who have knowledge, they're not like the people who don't have knowledge. The person who understands Tawheed, he understands that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where's Allah? Where's Allah? This is a serious question. If you fail to answer this question, and I get another, is so-and-so married? I'm gonna say no, but don't marry him, because he don't know the answer to this question. All right, where's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Above his throne. In a manner that fits his majesty, tabarak wa ta'ala. Allah said about himself, Ar-Rahmanu al-Arsh istawa. The Rahman rules above his throne. All right, so only thing we know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as it relates to where he is, that he's above his throne. We don't say that Allah exists without a place. We don't say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is everywhere. There's no proof to say that he's everywhere. There's no proof to say that he's in everything. Somebody say Allah is in everything. That if you say he's in everything, that means he's in the bathroom, in the toilet, the feces. How can you say that about your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala? Right? So Allah is above his throne. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked the slave girl one time, "Ain Allah?" Was Allah? She said, "Fis sama," yani فوق السماء, above the sky. Nah, above the sky. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Woman, ana, who am I?" She said, "You his messenger." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "اعتقها فإنها مؤمنة لا حق له." Verily, this woman is a believer. All right. Maybe a lot of proof in the Quran and the Sunnah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above his throne. The person who knows that and believes that and understands that, the person who knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a sami' and basir, he hears everything, he sees everything, right? That his life and his death is dependent upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's decision to either allow him to live or to take it away. This person is going to act differently. This is a reality, right? It's a reality. The people who have iman, the people who understand these things, they know the tawheed of Allah, they know Allah's names, his descriptions, the things that anger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the things that please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they're in a different category than the people who don't. So, of course, the people who have knowledge and the people who don't have knowledge, they're not the same. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in authentic narration, فضل العالم على العابد كفضل على أثناكم. He said the superiority that the scholar has over the regular worshiper is like the superiority that I have over the least one from amongst you. So imagine the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who Allah raised up, right, greater than everybody else in humanity, and then imagine the lowest person from amongst them. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was talking to the Sahaba, wallahu a'lam if he meant from the Sahaba or from humanity, but even if he was talking about the Sahaba, which clearly seems to be the dhahir, the clearest meaning of the narration, the least one from among the Sahaba in virtue, in status, in iman, in knowledge, in whatever. The difference between the scholar and the regular worshiper is like the difference between the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the least one from amongst them. So there's a big difference. Who determines a scholar, right? Who determines a scholar? Ulama, the scholars of our religion, who understands those who know what knowledge really is. Those who understand the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam better than everybody else. The one who understands the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam better than everybody else, those are the ones who are the most qualified to determine who a scholar is. If you want to go to medical school, right? Some of you, inshallah, are going to be doctors, right? If you want to go to medical school, nah, you can't. And may Allah make it easy for all of you who want it. Whatever it is you're doing, may Allah bless you all in it and make it easy for you. Okay? Whatever it is that you're studying, a person wants to be a doctor, you have to go to school, residency, and all these things until the doctor, the people on the board, say that you're qualified. When they say you're qualified, then you're a doctor. You want to be a cop, right? Not me, but if you want to be a cop, and you go through the police academy and whatever it is that they train you to do, you can't become a cop unless the people, the superiors, those people who train the police officers, those senior policemen, until they say you're a cop, you're not a cop. Why? Because they're the most knowledgeable as it relates to what it takes to be a cop or a police officer. So our religion is no different. You can't think just because the person has a lot of hits on YouTube, right? And that's the big thing. People are judging who you should listen to based on how many hits he has on YouTube. If that's the case, we should take it from Kevin Hart and Jay-Z and Beyonce. Because they have a lot of hits. The followers, how many followers you got on Twitter, we should take it from a whole lot of people that got 1.11 million, all of this. We should take it from them if it's based on how many hits you got on YouTube. Right? How much fame you have, how many followers. Who do you think got more followers? Dizzy Brother on YouTube or Shaytan? Shaitan got a lot of followers. He has a lot of supporters and followers. It's not based off of the crowd. Some of the prophets, alayhi salatu wasalam, going to be raised by Yom Qiyamah with no followers. People who rejected them, none. Does that mean that they were upon Baatil, that they were Jahil, and this innovator was upon the Haq because he had no followers? No. All right? a scholar. It's who the scholars of our religion from Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, al-Rabbaniyun, right? The people who understand the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the people who contextualize the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam based off of the contextualization of his companions, radiallahu anhu, those are the scholars. Okay, we're not talking about somebody who, you know, some weird stuff. He think he can make a supplication, conjure up the soul of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the room. We ain't talking about my life. We talk about the people of the Sunnah who take their books from the authentic, who take their knowledge from the authentic sources. Those are the scholars. When they decide that you're a scholar, then you're a scholar. Now, so many of our ulama, and we will ask this question throughout the years, I'm talking about over the last 15, 20 years alone, but that I witnessed myself over the last 15 years, the ulama, when they asked this question, they didn't mention many scholars, okay? They mentioned al-Imam, al-Hafiz, al-Muhaddith, Shaykh Abdul Aziz ibn Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala, wal-Allam, al-Muhaddith, al-Mujaddid, al-Imam Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani, rahmatullah alayhi, والإمام محمد بن صالح العثيمين رحمه الله، والإمام العلامة عبد الرحمن بن ناصر السعدي رحمه الله، أن الإمام أحمد النجم، والإمام المحدث مقبل الوادعي رحمه الله تعالى، أن الشيخ الإمام صالح الفوزان، الشيخ الإمام عبد العزيز آل الشيخ، والشيخ عبيد الجابري العلامة، والشيخ يعني المحدث عبد المحسن العبادي، من علماء. They mentioned a few names, so we mentioned some of the names that they mentioned. And there are many others, the Sheikh of Egypt, Muhammad Sa'id al-Aslan, Hafidhullah ta'ala, these are our ulama. Okay? People like, and I'm going to mention his name, Hamza Yusuf, these guys, they're not scholars, man. I'll tell them to their face if they were here. And they, I don't think that they would dispute that. They're not scholars. All right? I'm not going to mention names because I don't want to, you know, ruffle no feathers. But, you know, just don't believe the hype. All right? That's all I'm going to tell you. Remember the vice member of Bahadi? Anybody that tells you something, right? Anything you hear, specifically in your time, he was talking about over 1,000 years ago, so imagine now, right? Anything, any kalam, any speech you hear, examine it. From me or from anybody else. Any speech you hear, you examine it. You check it out and see if any of the companions of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam or any of the ulama talk about that issue. Okay, so we know who our scholars are, and inshallah ta'ala, we're going to continue to learn more about them and try to expose the ummah to all.